Hello, everybody. Andrea here with Dental L. Let's talk about your dental hygiene professional portfolio. So if you have been audited and you are submitting your portfolio, let me give you a quick recap on what you have to know. So basically, you need to have 75 hours worth of goals over the past 3 years, this year included. So the current year that you have been audited and then the previous 2 years from that. So you need to have 75 hours in total, and they have to be talking about your goals, because that's what they're going to look at. But 15 of those 75 hours can be non-goal related activities. So if you take a webinar on teeth whitening, but you don't necessarily have a goal that you want to talk about, then that can be included in your additional activities. I go through all of this inside my course online portfolio workshop if you need help. And inside the course, I do in include a free portfolio review where I will actually look at your portfolio before you submit to make sure you have everything in place that you need to know and what you have to do before you submit to hopefully avoid a phone call and an on-site visit. So I go through all of that inside the course. I also go through common errors that I do see in portfolios that I do review. And some of those are your goal titles aren't specific enough. They need to be specific. You can't just say you want to learn more about gingivitis, or you want to learn more about how to clean teeth, or you want to learn more about COVID. That's a very popular one lately. It has to be very specific. For example, you want to learn, so not just saying you want to learn more about gingivitis, but you want to learn more how to teach teenagers proper oral hygiene at home to prevent gingivitis. You see how specific that is. And then when you're taking webinars, have many webinars. So again, talking about gingivitis, you can have webinars about plaque, tartar, teenagers, oral hygiene, different toothbrushing techniques, different toothbrushing methods, manual toothbrush versus electric toothbrushes. I can help you guys with all of this inside the course. Don't worry. If you are overwhelmed, please just let me know. But see how easy that was. That took me like 5 seconds, but I know it can be very overwhelming, especially if you've never done the portfolio before. I've been audited twice in my 17 years in my dental hygiene profession. They audit us every 6 years or so. They started doing that, I want to say, 10 years ago. So I'm going to be audited again. So I want to help all of you guys so you don't have to be stressed, overwhelmed. So let me help you. Some other things that you have to know in regards to your portfolio is your report on learning has to be fantastic. Some common errors that I see is the report on learning is very short, maybe 2 bullet points. You might have 30 hours for that goal, but then 2 bullet points on your report on learning, the association is going to say that you took a goal for 30 hours, like 30 hours of studying, and you only learned 2 bullet points. There's no way. So you need to really pay attention to how many hours you are submitting per goal and make sure your report on learning is fantastic. The more you write, the better. Trust me. Don't be afraid to write too much. I love to see too much when I'm looking at these portfolios because that shows me you really know what you're talking about. If that shows me, that's going to show the association because you don't want them to call you to want clarification. So that's what can happen. If your assessor reviewing the portfolio and they are confused about things, then they're going to call you. What they do is they send you a letter or an email and say, "We have reviewed your portfolio. We would like to schedule a phone call." That's all they say. They don't say why, they don't say how, they don't say if you're in trouble. They just say, "We want to schedule a phone call." I've had a phone call too the last time I submitted my portfolio. I basically talked to them for half an hour. They wanted clarification because I am a restorative dental hygienist with a mobile dental hygiene practice. So they wanted to clarify with me that I knew when to separate my restorative hygiene duties, what I can do and what I can't do, which I thought was pretty obvious. You would think I would know that, which I do, but I didn't make that clear in my portfolio. So they wanted to make sure that I did know that. I have also had an on-site visit because of my mobile dental hygiene practice. What they told me was they're not used to a mobile dental hygienist in my area, So they wanted to assess my area because I see patients in my own home, but also mobile to their homes. But what I'm trying to say is I have lots of experience. I can help you guys with this. So basically, if your portfolio is clear and to the point with lots of information, they're not going to need clarification because you're giving it all to them. So let me help you guys. Less stress, less overwhelm, get it done before the holidays, okay? So I will leave the link for you guys down below. I do offer an online portfolio workshop. It is a full online course where I go through all of the information, how to write the goals, how to go through additional activities, how many hours you need. I talk about common errors that I see in portfolios and how you can avoid them. I talk about how to navigate through that phone call. If you do get a phone call, I help you through that, the types of questions they like to ask so you're prepared. I also go through how to navigate an on-site visit and how to be prepared for that. That's at the end of the course though, because I don't want you guys to worry about that yet. Just worry about your portfolio having the correct amount of hours, being specific with your goals in the title, having excellent bibliography for the activities, and a lot of report on learning. And if you need help, let me know. So thank you guys so much for watching. Good luck, and I'll talk to you guys in the next video.